Rebecca was born in January of 2016, and Reagan just instantly fell in love with her. I still remember her coming into the hospital and just holding her and staring at her, and we were just so thrilled. She was laying there, and the woman said to us, she didn't pass the newborn hearing screening, but not to worry, this happens all the time. It's most likely just fluid in her ears. But I knew in my gut at that moment that something wasn't right. A few tests later, they confirmed that Rebecca was profoundly deaf. After a couple months went by, we started to get really comfortable with her being deaf, and it was like, this is no big deal, we've got this. I started to notice that she still wasn't holding her head up the way I thought she should be, and I was reading about Usher syndrome, and I just had this awful feeling come over me, and I kind of knew.
We got the diagnosis that she had Usher syndrome and that she would eventually...
She'd eventually lose her vision. We realized that we had nothing under control. What we were expecting when Rebecca was born was not what was happening. So it took a while to accept that, you know? But she's beautiful and she's perfect and we love her so much and I couldn't imagine life without her. And we're gonna get through it and we're gonna get her through it. I realized rather quickly that there was nothing for a child of my daughter's age. I was looking for maybe a game, a children's book, something for her to play with on the way to learning Braille.
There are toys available, but they were what I viewed as the world feeling were good enough, and I just didn't see it being good enough.
When we're talking about things that a blind child comes in contact with in their daily life, and I'm talking about from the youngest of ages, you know, you're trying to stimulate them, and when you lack sight, finding stimulation is a very difficult thing to do for a parent.
Typically, Braille is accessed by young children only through the intentional efforts of adults. This is usually a kid's first Braille machine. It is quite heavy, so usually they don't carry it around themselves. This is not a toy. You can't really play with it much. It will get jammed if you push down on all the keys and mess with them too much.
You wanted to go to college, you want to graduate from high school. The high school rate of graduation is something like 45%. We want her to experience what everyone else experiences in life.
Well, I've known Jake for 6 years. He is tireless. I'm usually in here pretty early, and Jake's usually here before me, and he's here often after me.
I started to tinker with some things and take some past experience and realize that I could actually create a low-cost pre-Braille toy.
This strikes me as something that can both entertain and educate a child about this object can be represented by these dots. Take an item, place it on the reader screen, and have it magically appear as a series of dots in a particular pattern. That's pretty interactive. Inexpensive tech, simplified tech, durable tech, and tech that is the precursor to using the tech that I train people to use here every day. I'd love to see more people pass through my doors being Braille literate and knowing that that was going to help them find employment and a lifetime of learning.
Brian, how are you?
Hey.
Good to see you.
Good to see you. Good to have you stopping by. Stopping by. We're gonna work together well, you know that, don't you?
We do. Yes, sir. And then I find myself in the office at home till 2 a.m. just tinkering with this thing. It was fun. I mean, I was having fun. This was my way of dealing with... It definitely helped me cope. And then when I figured out, you know, that I could help other people,
it's like this was what he was meant to do. He has such passion and drive and focus, and it's absolutely amazing.
So I hear Beth's the star of the film.
Oh yeah, I was just like, I was the guy who cried the whole time.